This is the scene outside of the immigration department on Tuesday, June 26, as people are still awaiting their passports.
According to Home Affairs Minister Dr. Virginia Albert Poyet, the immigration department has faced several challenges in the rollout of passports. The major one is the limited staff complement due to air quality issues within the building.
There is a problem with the building and the air quality. We just did a recent test and we find that the air quality in the building is still not up to the standard that we would want. And at this point, the Department of Home Affairs is looking at alternative venue for us to get the workers. I think there may be a shortage of workers because a few persons have indicated some little problems with their skin. So that would create some kind of delay. And since we are introducing the new passport, there is a backlog of persons who are waiting. So that is the reason you would have seen so many people line up, because a number of persons had applied for the old passport and now they are coming in for their new passport. So there is a rush to try and get their passport now.
The Home Affairs Minister reveals that with a backlog of over 1,000 passports and the limited staff complement, the ministry is taking measures to ensure that the process is consistent. However, she says the immigration department should implement a better communication strategy to mitigate public anxiety.
We have about over 1,000 persons waiting for their new passport. So that's a huge amount to clear. And we are also in the process of increasing the staff so that we can expedite the process. So maybe in the next week or 2 weeks, and I think what the department will have to do is to send announcements to the people and let them know that there is a certain quota, so they do not have people waiting for a whole day and know they will not get attention. So you see, we allow X number per day. So once you come in, you take your number, and you notice you have passed the number, then it doesn't make sense for you to wait in a long line outside and hoping that you will get service for the day.
Dr. Poyet also reveals that the issuing of emergency passports has been, and in some cases, still being dealt with. However, there remains a looming concern for persons wishing to use their passports as a secondary form of identification.
It is not the government's fault that the people don't have a passport as a second form of identification. There are several other forms of identification. It's just that some people chose to use passport as one of the forms of identification. And the bank that put in their own regulation, I mean, we had discussions with the central bank, and it is not something that is mandatory across all banks in the Caribbean. So it is the banks in St. Lucia who are looking for. And I mean, for security purposes, you want persons to have more than one form of ID, for if in case their first form of ID has been tampered with. So I don't blame the bank for seeking a second form of identification, but some persons have several different forms of identification. It so happened that some people may just have their ID and depending on their passport.
But has there been a discussion with the banks to allow some sort of leeway for that to happen?
I don't think we, that is, will deal with Ministry of Finance to handle issue of banking and so on. So I don't think there have been that kind of discussion. They put their stipulation for their own security purposes, and sometimes we cannot interfere with banking process.
The Immigration Department continues to face its fair share of challenges compounded by the government's limited fiscal space. For the DBS News World, I am Jason Darius.